for New York Automobile Dealers Association, the organization that owns and operates the New York International Auto Show. It's my pleasure to welcome you here today and to thank you for attending our show and for joining us for the presentation of the third annual World Car of the Year Awards held here in New York City. Over the past 3 years, the world's best cars have received the recognition they deserve right here in this room at this event. In 2006, the BMW 3 Series captured the top honors, beating out a field of 27 competitors and taking home the inaugural World Car of the Year Award at the New York International Automobile Show. Last year, the Lexus LS460 was declared the World Car of the Year, topping a field of 28 contenders. And very shortly, we will find out who's taking home the 2008 award. We are pleased that this global awards program is taking place right here where it should, in the Big Apple, at North America's first and largest attended auto show. Auto shows are a great way for car buyers to get a glimpse of new cars and trucks that are about to hit the streets. And this award program is a great way to showcase the very best that the auto industry has to offer. It's a program that's been developed by the toughest critics around, 47 of the world's top automotive journalists. And when you pass their test, you know you've made it. Before I introduce the host of this morning's event, I would like to recognize all of the manufacturers here today and congratulate them for making it into the top three. It's now my pleasure to introduce to you the co-chairs of the World Car of the Year program, Mr. Peter Lyon and Mr. Jerry Malloy.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Peter Lyon. I am one of the co-chairs of the World Car of the Year Awards, and I write for the publications you see up on the screen.
And my name is Jerry Malloy. I'm also one of the co-chairs, and these are my outlets.
From all of us involved in the World Car of the Year program, our sincere thanks to the New York International Auto Show for their generous hosting of this press conference, as well as their support throughout the year.
We have an impressive array of auto company executives with us this morning, whom we would like to recognize. From Audi, Johann Denischen, Executive Vice President of Audi North America. From BMW, Tom Purvis, Chairman and CEO, BMW US Holding. From Mazda, Keiichi Wakabayashi, General Manager, Global Communications Planning. From Mercedes-Benz, Christoph Horn, Head of Global Communications. From Smart, Anders Jensen, Head of the Smart Brand. From Volkswagen, Wolfgang Hatz, from VW Technical Development, VW AG. And from Volvo, Steve Armstrong, COO of Volvo Corporation, and Steve Martin, Chief Design Director from Volvo Corporation. Thank you all for being here and for supporting the World Car of the Year program. Please give them all a hand.
We'd also like to take this opportunity to thank the Midway Group for their continued support of the World Car of the Year Awards and for making this awards ceremony possible since 2006. Specifically, we would like to thank David Smith, Senior Corporate Account Manager, and invite him to say a few words. David.
Thank you, Peter. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow members of the global automotive industry, good morning. Today we're here to honor something very special. Once started as a sketch in a design studio, long ago, graduating to a clay model in an engineering lab, eventually scaling itself to the financial and executive offices where the respective teams once pitched their superiors, begging and fighting for the funding and the important green light to bring that dream to life. Through the efforts of the World Car Steering Committee and jurors from around the world, the work of some of the hundreds of thousands of passionate members of the global automotive collaboration is being acknowledged here today. As your babies have become finalists in their performance, design, green, and World Car of the Year categories, congratulations on your achievements. As a preferred supply partner to the global automotive industry, serving our clients since 1953, Midway Group is proud of its long-standing relationships to each of you as a whole. Whatever you need, whether it be to acquire a comparative vehicle for your prototype, whether you need hundreds of vehicles to service your sales training, marketing, or consumer interactive programs, perhaps a middle-of-the-night delivery, or just an idea, the Midway Group Vehicle Supply, Transportation, Insurance, and Market Data Team stand tall and ready. Tall and ever ready to provide an immediate access and service point anywhere in the world, be it your office locally or that of your international teams, we are driven by one simple mantra: consider it done. On behalf of our entire firm, thank you. Thank you for your trust, thank you for your confidence, and thank you for the opportunity to serve you today. It is a pleasure for us to support the World Car of the Year as an official sponsor, and it is a pleasure speaking this morning. Congratulations to the nominees. Thank you.
Thank you, David. We would also like to thank the international accounting firm KPMG, who tabulate and audit the jurors' ballots in two rounds of voting in January, then again in early spring. The World Car of the Year Awards represents an opportunity to recognize and reward automotive excellence on a global scale and to make consumers aware of that recognition. To that end, World Car of the Year is a program initiated by, organized by, and conducted by automotive journalists from around the globe.
From the outset, those of us involved in making it a reality have done so in the context of one overriding priority. That is, we are dedicated to ensuring that it's carried out with the utmost objectivity, credibility, and integrity. It's administered by a nonprofit association under the guidance of a steering committee of five distinguished journalists from Asia, Europe, and North America, all of whom are with us here today.
A jury of 47 experienced automotive journalists from 24 countries individually reviewed, evaluated, and voted on the entrants by secret ballot in two separate rounds of voting. We have with us today steering committee directors Dan Carney and John McCormick from the United States, Matt Davis from Italy, as well as several other jurors from around the world. Our steering committee members will each present one of the awards. Here to begin the process is my colleague, Matt Davis. Matt.
Thank you, Peter. To be eligible for the World Green Car Award, a vehicle must be all new or substantially revised, in production and introduced for sale to consumers in at least one major market between January 1st and December 31st of 2007. In addition, the vehicles must satisfy one or more of the green criteria shown on the screen. Alternatively, the vehicle or technology may be a prototype or experimental vehicle with near future application, provided that it A, addresses today's environmental issues per the criteria listed on the screen, and B, has been released for individual or press fleet evaluations in quantities of 10 or more. The three finalists this year are the BMW 118D with efficient dynamics, the Smart for 2 CDI, and the Volkswagen Passat 1.9 TDI Blue Motion. And the World Green Car winner for 2008 is the BMW 118D with efficient dynamics. Here to accept the award on behalf of BMW is CEO and Chairman of BMW Holding US, Tom Purvis.
Very, very briefly, ladies and gentlemen, it's terrific that we have this accolade. Our organization has put so much effort into efficient dynamics. I think it's terrific, by the way, that all three of the finalists are diesels. It marks a moment this year when we will bring diesel technology to the United States. It will not only be efficient, it will also be dynamic. I'm delighted that we've won this award. I think it's an accolade for our engineers, for our designers, for the whole organization. Congratulations also to the other finalists. Wonderful products that they are. Efficient dynamics for us represents a whole field of technology from auto start-stop right through to turbo diesels, hydrogen cars of the future. Thank you very much indeed. We're deeply, deeply honored to receive this award. Wonderful. Thank you.
And here now to present the World Car Design winner for the year 2008 is my fellow steering committee director, John McCormick.
Thank you, Matt. Style sells. No matter how rational a buyer's approach to a new car purchase may be, the ultimate decision is typically based as much on emotion as on reason, perhaps more so. Nothing evokes that emotion more strongly than a vehicle's appearance, be it a sports car or a minivan or anything in between. The candidates for World Car Design of the Year were chosen from the eligible list of cars for the overall World Car of the Year award. A panel of four internationally recognized design experts reviewed the initial list of candidates, then made recommendations to the jurors. The four design experts were Sylvia Barafulde of Auto and Design magazine, Robert Cumberford from Automobile, Akira Fujimoto from Car Styling magazine, and Tom Matano from the Academy of Art University in San Francisco. The World Car jurors then voted on the experts' recommended shortlist. And the three finalists are the Audi R8, the Mazda 2, Mazda Demio, and the Volvo C30. And the World Car Design of the Year 2008 is... the Audi R8. And here to accept the award is Johan Denason of Audi North America. Johan.
Well, it truly is an honor and a privilege to be here, and for the efforts of the entire team at Audi to be recognized in this fashion. You might think that with cars like this, I don't have to say anything because the cars speak for themselves, and you would be right. But it also probably is suitable that I should just lament on my lot. As the head of Audi in America, I truly believe in the law of averages, and we had a reception at the Audi Forum yesterday evening, and one of our guests, looking at a range of cars, said, "You guys have such a hot product line, life must be easy." And of course, if the law of averages didn't prevail, that would be true. But at the time when we have got these great cars, the dollar decides to go south just to keep our life interesting. But again, it is, for us, yet another milestone to have the efforts of our designers recognized in this fashion by this august body. And as we now seek to bring to the people here in North America as well the essence of what Audi is all about, in the same way that we are already recognized in most of the other parts of the globe, it's a matter of awareness. And certainly here, a halo car, if you like, such as the R8, certainly plays an important role. And again, it's an absolute honor and privilege to be recognized in this fashion, for which I thank you. Thank you.
Johan. Here to present the World Performance Car Award is my fellow steering committee director, Dan Carney from the US. Dan.
This year, WorldCar is pleased to acknowledge the presentation of the World Performance Car Award by Mobil 1. Here to say a few words is Nancy Carlson, Strategic Global Alliances Manager, ExxonMobil Lubricants and Specialties.
Well, good morning, everyone, and thank you, Dan, for your kind introduction. And on behalf of ExxonMobil and Mobil 1, I'd like to extend a warm welcome to the International New York Auto Show. But more importantly, the presentation today of the World Car of the Year Awards. I'd also like to thank some of you in the audience today for your business. I've seen some of our customers this morning, and it's great to see many of you. As Dan shared, I'm Nancy Carlson. I'm the sales director for our Strategic Global Alliance team, who works very closely with many of the manufacturers around the world, whether they be in Asia, Europe, or the United States. And we also look after many of the motorsports associations that we enjoy with Mobil 1 as well. One of ExxonMobil's fundamental business principles is our commitment to technology. And I think no one product, certainly in our lineup, reflects that technology better than Mobil 1. And as automotive technologies evolve, and we see many of them in the room today, certainly Mobil 1 will evolve, and we will be very ready for the future fuels that evolve, as well as some of the new technologies that are emerging across the board. As the proud sponsor of the 2008 World Performance Car Award today, it's now our turn, Mobil 1's turn, to recognize the top performance cars. We're very excited to be here. This is the first year we've done such a sponsorship, and hopefully we'll be back again next year. So on behalf of Mobil 1 all around the world, we'd like to congratulate each one of these vehicles, which are winners in their own right. Certainly the Audi R8, the Audi S5 Coupe, and the BMW M3, all spectacular products. So we wish you all good luck, and we're anxious to hear the winner, Dan. So thanks again.
Thank you, Nancy. The three finalists for 2008 World Performance Car are the Audi R8, the Audi S5 Coupe, and the BMW M3. The winner of 2008 World Performance Car of the Year is Audi R8. Here to accept the award is Johan de Nijs.
That is just great. I've heard about having to sing for your supper, but I've had to sing for my breakfast now as well. The R8 is truly doing an amazing job in bringing brand recognition for Audi around the globe. The car has captured the imagination of people everywhere, and I think as our performance car flagship, it again is very, very pleasing to be recognized and rewarded in this fashion. Audi certainly is a company now that is on a mission. Our sales growth and profitability growth continues unabated. 12 successive volume records and profitability records just completed again last year with a return on sales of 8.7%, making us one of the most profitable companies in the world. And I think that we're earning our success, and we certainly will continue our relentless march despite the tough economic circumstances that are prevailing around the world to break through the 1 million barrier this year. But the product offensive clearly is at the heart of our business. One of the earlier speakers spoke about the designers and engineers having to go to the executive offices and plead for the resources to fund their latest ideas. At Audi, there isn't that much pleading. We have a $15 billion $1 billion product development offensive that will manifest itself in the next few years, and we certainly hope that this relentless pace of product innovation will continue unabated, and that it too will be recognized in this August forum. Thank you very much for the recognition, and I think that we look forward to the continued success of the World Car of the Year program. And while I also would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all the other finalists, and I will now hold my breath with anticipation for the announcement of the World Car of the Year. Thank you very much.
And now it's time to declare the overall winner of the 2008 World Car of the Year. The jurors voted for this award not once, but twice in two separate levels of balloting. The jurors assessed the cars on the basis of 20 separate parameters, ranging from styling and comfort to performance and fuel economy. For their final selection, they rated the 10 finalists on 6 key areas of importance to potential customers, as shown on the screen. Those secret ballots were collected and tabulated by the international accounting firm, KPMG, to whom we also express our sincere gratitude.
Thank you, Dan. As you may have guessed from the presence of the Ford Mondeo, Mazda 2, Mazda Demio, and the Mercedes-Benz C-Class on the stage, these three vehicles topped the overall score sheets. As was the case for each of the finalists in the other three categories, that makes them winners already. They have to be exceptional cars just to make it into the final three. And these cars are exceptional. Each model elevates the bar in its own segment and delivers outstanding quality, handling, and safety. We salute them and their manufacturers for being here on stage and for the benchmark status each enjoys within the industry. But now, it's down to the three behind me. In just a moment, one will be crowned as the fourth annual World Car of the Year. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready? And the winner of the World Car of the Year for 2008 is the Mazda 2 Mazda Demio. And accepting the award for Mazda is Mr. Keiichi Wakabayashi, General Manager, Global Communications.
Watch out, it's a bit slippery.
Ladies and gentlemen, Thank you very much. Mazda is and the Mazda Group and all the employees are delighted to have won this prestigious 2008 World Car of the Year Award. This is a very wonderful recognition that Mazda 2 owners and Mazda employees alike can celebrate this worldwide. The all-new Mazda 2 is exceeding our highest expectations, demonstrating that it can compete against the best compact cars in the world and any market in the world. And we have also won a number of Car of the Year awards around the globe. Winning the World Car of the Year award is made even more significant by the fact that the winner is chosen by the diverse selection of automotive journalists from all around the world. Asia, Africa, Europe, North America, all the continents. It is truly a global award. We humbly accept this award, and on behalf of all Mazda employees, all Mazda customers, and all the automotive industry people, a very big thank you to the World Car of the Year jury members. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Watabayashi.